Good day to all of you. As you all know, on the first day of the week, we learn something new, and in the next class, we revise what we have learned. So today, you will be revising what you learned in the previous class. Let us now begin the revision of the previous class. Can you tell why we use numbering and bullets? If you want to prepare a list and you want to put different symbols in front of each of these lines, then you will use the bullets option. You can use the bullets option to put bullets in front of each line. If, however, you wish to put numbering in front of each line, you will use the numbering option. Can you tell how we can set the margin for a page? If you want to set the margin for a page, then you will be using the page submenu of the format menu. This will help you to leave a margin on your page. Can you tell which submenu of the format menu will help you to change the background color of the text? If you want to change the background color of your text, then you can do this with the help of the character submenu's background option. Can you tell what happens with page background? Using page background, you can change the background of your page. You can also change the color of the background of the page, and you can also put in an image in the background. Can you tell what happens with the border option? You can use the border option to get a border on all four sides of the page. This brings a line on all four sides of the page. If you want, you can put a border on just the top and bottom of the page, or even on just the left and right of the page. You can change the size of the line and also the style of the line. The line's color can also be changed with this option. Next, all of you, power on your computer and using the method told to you, open the writer file. Let us now see which all options you will practice today. You will first practice the character submenu. Then you will practice some of the options of the paragraph also. Next, you will practice using bullets and numbering. And then you will practice some options of the page. Have you all been able to open the writer file? If you are facing problems, you can ask for help. Now, type out the paragraph being shown in front of you. Have you all typed out the paragraph? If you have not typed it, then finish typing quickly so that you can practice also. First of all, after selecting the full paragraph, using the character submenu, change the paragraph size. Change the style of writing and show that you can overline this paragraph. If you face any problems, watch the video and learn from it. In this video, we will learn and practice the use of changing font styles. As is being shown in the video, select the paragraph and then bring your pointer to the format option of the menu bar. Click there and then click on character option. Then from the box, select the font option or the font tab. And here, just below the font, you see so many styles of the font or styles of writing. If you scroll up or down, you can see many options are available. Select any of the options that you like. Click on that option, the option that you like, and then click on OK. So this will, once you click on OK, it will get applied to the paragraph that you had selected, as is being shown in the video. Now let's see how we can change the font size of our paragraph. In this video, we will learn and practice the use of changing font styles, changing the font size, and overlining on the paragraph. To change the font style, first you need to select your text or paragraph or line, as is being shown in the video. Select the paragraph and then bring your pointer to the format option of the menu bar. Click there and then click on character option. And when the box opens, once again come to the font option or the font tab. And in this, at the end, you can see the size option. If you scroll up and down, you can see that the size keeps becoming bigger. If you scroll down, and if you scroll up, it becomes smaller. So select the size that you would like. For instance, we are selecting 22 and then click on OK. Once you click on OK, you will see that the selected paragraph font, the size of the font changes to 22. Like this. Now let us see in this video how we can overline on top of our paragraph. Again, to get an overline, we need to select our paragraph, take the pointer to the format option, click here, and then click on the character option. And from the box which opens, now select the font effects tab or option, click on that. And in this, you can see the overlining option in the middle. So if you click on the down arrow, you see various options are available. You can scroll up and down and choose whichever overlining option you like, like single, double, bold, dotted, dotted bold, and like you can scroll up and down and see more options and select one and then click on OK, by doing which you will see that your paragraph will get an overline on top of it. Next, on the same paragraph, using the character submenu, show how you will change the font color, change the text to small letters, and then change it back to capital letters, and then show how double underlining is done. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn. This video will help us to practice changing the font color, changing the paragraph font into small capitals, and underlining. So to make these changes on the paragraph, you need to first select the paragraph. Select the paragraph as is being shown in the video and then bring your pointer to the format menu. Click on that and click on character option. In this, select the font effects tab or the option, and you see the font color option. When you click on the down arrow, you can see many colors. If you scroll up or down, you can see a variety of other colors available. So you can choose the color that you like and then click on OK, which will apply the color to your font in the paragraph that you have selected. Now, let's watch in the video how we can change this paragraph font into small capital font. Again, for this, select the paragraph as is being shown in the video. Bring the pointer to the format option of the menu bar. Select character option, and again in the font effects option, you can see the effects option. When you click on the down arrow, you will see the variations available, which are capital, lowercase, and then also small capitals. So you click on small capitals. And click on OK, and this will apply on your text, or your text will become in small capitals. Now we are going to watch how we can do underlining. Again, to apply the change, you need to select the paragraph. So select the paragraph first, and then bring your pointer to the format menu or the format option on the menu bar. Click on character option, and from this box, when you are in font effects, look for the underlining option, which is being shown to you in the video. When you click on the down arrow, you will see many options available, like single, double, bold, dotted, dotted, bold. If you scroll up and down, you can see other options also. Select the one which you like for underlining and then click on OK. So this will apply the underlining on your selected text. Next, using the paragraph submenu, show how you can leave space in the beginning and then after the paragraph. Then change the first word of the paragraph by drop caps. Finally, show a border around this paragraph. If you have any doubts, then watch and learn from the video. With this video, we will learn and practice the use of applying indents to the paragraph and also using drop caps. So to apply the indent, you need to first select the paragraph as is being shown in the video. Select this paragraph. And then take your pointer to the format option of the menu bar, click on that, and then click on the paragraph option. From the box which opens, click on the indent and spacing tab or the indent and spacing option. Here below indent you can see before text and after text. So if you want to apply space before text, use the before text option. Come here to the up arrow button and click on it to increase the space between the paragraph and the left text boundary. And then click on OK, and you will see that the space gets applied on your selected paragraph. There is space between the left text boundary and where the paragraph begins. If you want to apply space on the end of the paragraph, or apply an indent at the end of the paragraph, again select the paragraph, go to the format option, select that, and then select paragraph, and in here use the after text option. Click on the up arrow button to increase the space between the paragraph and the right text boundary. So when you click on OK, you can see that the space has got applied to the end of the paragraph also. Now let's see how we can apply drop caps on this paragraph. To apply drop caps, select the paragraph as is being shown in the video, and then take your pointer to the format option, click on that, and again select the paragraph option by clicking. From the box, click on the drop caps tab or the drop caps option. You will see that the various selections or the options are not highlighted. Once you click on display drop caps, the tick mark appears and the options appear. Now the first one is for number of characters. Since we want to just apply drop caps on the first character, we will leave it as 1. Then the lines that we want the drop caps character to cover, you can increase it by the up arrow tab or button, or decrease it by the down arrow button. So if you keep 3, it will be applied in front of 3 lines. Then you can increase or decrease the space between the drop caps character and the lines. So we are keeping it at 0 and clicking on OK, and you see that the drop caps gets applied in front of 3 lines. The first letter of the first word appears in a big capital. Next, divide the paragraph into 2 parts and show how bullets and numbering is used. Learn from the video if you face any problems. With this video, we will practice the use of bullets and numbering. So to apply the bullets and numbering, we will first divide this paragraph into 2 parts so that in one part we can apply bullets and in the other we can apply numbering. So bring your cursor to somewhere in the middle of this paragraph at the end of this line here, as is being shown in the video, and press the enter key. So once you press the enter key, you will see that your paragraph gets divided into 2 parts. Now let us bring our cursor to the beginning of the first paragraph in front of the T, which is being shown in the video. We need to go take our pointer to the format option of the menu bar and then click on the bullets and numbering option. A box opens and you see many types of, you can click on the bullets option here or the bullets tab, and you see many types of bullets that you can apply. So select the one which you want to use and click on OK, and you will see a bullet has been applied. Now you can close the bullets and numbering toolbar from this cross here. Next, to put numbering on the second paragraph, we bring our cursor here, click here before the H, and then take our pointer to the format option in the menu bar, click there, click again on the bullets and numbering option, and this time from the box we will click on the tab which says numbering type or the option for numbering. Click there and you see many varieties of numbering. Choose the one which you like to use, like this one, and then click on OK. And you will see a number applies on the paragraph. You can close the bullets and numbering toolbar from here. This is how you use bullets and numbering. Put today's date as the header and insert the page number as the footer. If in doubt, learn from the video. In this video, we will practice the use of the header and the footer. So in order to get a header on your writer page, you need to bring your pointer to the format option of the menu bar and then click on page option, and from this box click on the header option or the header tab. Now the various options are not highlighted. Click on header on. You will see a tick mark and the options get highlighted. Now, if you want to increase the left margin from the text boundary of the header, you can use the left margin option. If you want to increase the right margin, you will use the right margin option. So, if you want to increase this, the left margin, you will click here. In case of the right margin, you will click on the up arrow button shown here, or you can decrease it. So like this, now if you want to increase the spacing between the header and the top text boundary, you can increase it from this up arrow button and click on OK. So you will see that your header gets inserted. Now since we have to insert in this header the date, we will bring our cursor here and click on it and then take the pointer to the insert menu of the menu bar. Click on insert and then from here choose the fields option. And within the fields, click on the date option and you will see that the date gets inserted in the header of your writer page. Now, since you also want to insert a footer, once again, you will need to take your pointer to the format option of the menu bar, as is being shown in the video. Click here and then again click on the page option. In this box, now you have to select the footer tab or the footer option. So click there. And you will see that the options are not highlighted. To highlight them, you have to click on footer on. Once you click there, the options get highlighted. Now you can again increase the left margin or the right margin, which is from the text boundaries for the footer. So let us see how we can increase the left margin from this button, up arrow button. Or decrease it from this lower button. Spacing also you can increase by this up arrow button. And if you also want to increase the height of the footer itself, you can use this button. Click on OK. And now you can just scroll down and see that your footer has got inserted. Click within the footer with your pointer because you want to insert the page number here. So take the pointer now to the insert option in the menu bar. Click on that and then click on fields option and from the options available, click on page number. So you will see that the page number gets inserted in your footer. So this is how you can use the header and the footer on your writer page. And then change the background of the page. Watch the video to learn more about this. This video helps us to practice changing the background color of the writer page. To change the background color of the writer page, let's first select the paragraph on our page. After selecting it, let's go to Format option of the menu bar. And click on page option. From the box that opens, click on the background tab or the background option. And you will see that in this there are two options. If you click here on the down arrow button, there are two options, color and graphic. So you can change the color of the background or add a graphic in the background. Since we just want to change the color, we select color. And then from the box here, we select the color that we like and click on OK. And you will see that the color of the background of your writer page changes to the selected color. Since we will end this class here, all of you should save your writer file at some place on your computer and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, all of you learned about some of the options of the format submenu like font color, overlining, underlining and also about options of the paragraph like header and footer. Lastly, you all practiced with the page submenu. Thank you.